Good morning. It is Thursday, the 17th of January, 2019. Thank you for joining us today. Project developers should adhere sale agreements. Political party VHP celebrates the 70th anniversary. Workshop on trauma held by Matuku Foundation. And Suriname requests the extradition of Raj Udit. The Minister of Public Works, Transport and Communications, Patrick Pengel, warns housing developers who do not adhere to the sales agreements with their customers. According to Pengel, there are clear rules when it comes to developing housing projects. This year, the ministry will carry out more inspections on these project developers. Buyers of a plot in the project Abigail's Lust also have problems with their seller. The residents say that according to the agreement, the roads should be hardened. There would also be water and electricity. But after 4 years, these agreements have not been yet fulfilled. But the buyers, it is, are tired of waiting and want the Ministry of Public Works to intervene. The minister indicates that the entrepreneurs must comply with the agreements because people are working hard to pay off their partial. The STVS News made contact with a project developer, and he says that he has already received the tender from the utility companies. Next week, he will pay the bill as agreed in the partial agreement so that the people can be connected to the water and electricity grid. After 70 years, the rapprochement policy of Jagannath Lachman must be experienced internally within the political party VHP. According to the current chairman, Chandrika Prasad Santokhi, this is the challenge of the party. At the creation of the party by Lachman, the reconciliation was part of the basic idea of the VHP. The party has always participated in the elections. In 1969, together with the PNP of Shoesetney, the party received government responsibility for the first time. After the military takeover in 1980, exponents of the VHP also had a seat in cabinets that were formed during that time. For example, Pratap Radhakisung was Minister of Natural Resources, Rajkumar Ranjit Singh was Minister of Public Works, and Shoes Ajoja, Minister of Justice and Police. After the military period, the party always has, in combination with the NPS, participated in the elections and sat three times in the government. To bear in mind that right before the independence of 1975, the VHP and the NPS were diametrically opposed. Santokhi says that the party is working on the rehabilitation of George Hindari. According to the party, Hindari committed treason by voting for independence in 1975. But the Surinamese community sees George Hindari as the hero who helped to make Suriname independent from the Netherlands. Saturday, the VHP will organize various activities in connection with the 70th anniversary of the party. Guiding people with a traumatic experience requires knowledge and skills. Often young children have already experienced certain events that affect their choices and decisions as adults. Adults also experience events both emotionally and physically. It is a certain kind of experience that can result in fear. In collaboration with the Ministry of Social Affairs and Housing, the Foundation Matuku provides a workshop on trauma. During this workshop, you will gain more insight into recognition and understanding of what trauma is. The sessions start today and they end tomorrow. The Dutch judiciary is asked to pronounce a verdict if Raj Udit will be extradited to the Surinamese justice. So says his lawyer, Erwin Kanhai. The entrepreneur was arrested in the Netherlands upon request of Suriname. Udit is associated with the discovery of an airplane with almost 500 kilos of drugs on his premises last year in March. And according to Erwin Kanhai, his client is willing to cooperate with the investigation, but now he is forced to stay in the Netherlands due to health issues. That is all for the local news for today. Have a wonderful and pleasant day further. Until tomorrow. Bye-bye.